What's up, folks? Dave Swift here, and you're watching another edition of That LTD Life, the series where I make it my life's mission to find you the best software tools without expensive reoccurring costs. Today, we're looking at screen recording, a Loom replacement type of tool. This is Dadan over on AppSumo. Dadan is part of AppSumo's AI Week, which means for the next 3 days, you're going to be able to get the best price ever on Dadan. More on that in a little bit. But first, let's just get into the tool and find out how it works. All right, here we go. I've now switched computers entirely. I'm now on my laptop, which has a built-in camera. You're still hearing the audio from my external recorder, but the video you're seeing is from the camera on my laptop. So we're looking at Dadan right now. This is their web app. The recording actually takes place via a Chrome extension or an Edge extension. I should note that they do have a macOS application coming that will work with Safari, but that's not available as of the recording of this video. So essentially, I'm doing a Dadan recording right now. We can see my video in the lower left-hand corner. Now that is something I can move around with my mouse, so I can grab it and position it wherever I like on the screen. One thing you can't do, however, is actually move these controls so that they're not visible. You'll always be able to see that, and it is burned into the final product. So just be aware of that. It's not a big deal, but if you're looking to do like ultra high professional quality screen recordings, this probably isn't going to give you the cleanest output. But there are some nifty little tools here. So I can open this up and I can actually draw right on the screen. That is really cool, especially if you're maybe doing support for clients and you want to be able to point out things like, hey, click right here, do that. You know, you can be Network Chuck. You can act like Network Chuck in your Loom style videos. There's boxes you can draw. You can do circles as well. Now these are going to disappear after 10 seconds. That is what this 10S means. If I just sit here for about 10 seconds, everything should dissolve. We'll see here in a minute if it does. At least the typing, definitely. Oh, there we go. It clears out. Now, that doesn't have to be the case. You can turn that off if you want it to stay up permanently. You can do that. And if you are actually, here's a little emoji picker. Oops, I thought I was on the emojis. All right, now we can pick a little emoji. We can draw this. And let's say, all right, that is not something I want to stick around for 10 seconds. I can just click this button. Everything disappears. So we can write on the screen. There is a text tool. And of course, we can change colors of things as well. So overall, the screen recording experience is pretty nice, especially for doing instructional grade material. Now, I've got my entire window here inside of Chrome being recorded, which means I can switch tabs, but you could also do a screen recording of the entire screen, or you could do just one particular tab. It prompts you that when you start the recording. Everything else is kind of what you'd expect it to be. We can turn off the camera if you don't want to have that on. You change your mind halfway through the recording. You can also change the shape of the camera view as well. There's this kind of full screen view. If you want to maybe take over the screen for a moment, you can do that. Okay, so those are kind of the basic, oh, where did my camera go here? Those are kind of the basic tools that you'll find inside of the screen recording, but that's not even close to everything Dadan can do. So let's actually stop this recording. We'll stop this recording. And now I'm back over on my regular screen recording tool with my fancy external camera. So I expect the video quality probably improves a lot here. That's not anything to do with Dadan. That's because I'm using an expensive external camera. And I'm using CleanShot X to record the Dadan interface because obviously when you're using Dadan, you can't see this. So I've just stopped the recording in Dadan and it gives me a link right away, which I love. So I can copy the link, share it with somebody who needs to see whatever I'm showing them. I can also download the file directly to my PC or my Mac if I want to be able to edit it further or just save it for posterity's sake. That's really cool. But what gets even better is if I go back to my library inside of Dadan, I'm going to see that video show up here. I'll probably have to reload because I've already had the page loaded. And here we go. This is going to be the video that I just finished recording 6 minutes ago. And you can see it's got a view count here. I can click the triple dots. I can move this to a folder, favorite it. All right, kind of basic stuff, right? Well, let's open it up inside of the editor here. And you can see I've got all of these AI tools. There's an integration with Google Classroom, which I've never used, but I understand the kids are using it for school these days. And there's also an editor where I can do a lot of additional things, like a full-blown editor where I can literally trim up the video. I'll open this up and we can check it out. Now, this is obviously not going to replace something like Premiere Pro or Final Cut Pro, but if you're not a pro user and you just want to add some fanciness to your video or trim up a bad take, it's very easy to do so. In fact, let's start off with trimming. I think that's probably the most common request. I really like this implementation. It's very easy to understand. So I just click the trim button here and then I get a trim section. So anywhere in the video, if I wanted to trim this part up, let's say it was a bad take, I can just position it right here. And now as I do the playback, it's just going to skip. As soon as it hits this part, it'll skip to the end right here, and nothing in the middle will actually be seen. Let's check that out. I'll hit play. There you go. You saw it just jump over that section. So very, very easy to use. There's some fun stuff in here like emojis, stickers, and shapes as well. Very similar to what we saw inside of the annotation tools. But yeah, if I wanted to drop in an emoji, I could easily drop that right here. And very similar to what we saw before, the emoji is going to appear as long as this playhead is in length. So if I want it to appear the entire video, I would just drag it from end to end. And if I only wanted the end of the video, I'd position it over there. There are some alignment tools here. If you want to have it very precise, you can do that, or obviously just click and drag where you want it to go. The other tools like text and blur are very basic. It's just going to get you kind of the bare minimum for what you want to do. It's totally fine to send to colleagues, but I would probably not create a professional YouTube channel using only this tool. So for example, text, I can simply open up the text tool, choose the basic text that I want. Let's say I wanted a monospace. I can do that. It just positions here on the screen. You got the same interface to position it where we want it to go, and you just simply type your text. Now, the other feature like a blur, very similar, just position it where you want it to go and then choose where it shows up in the video. It's very snappy and fast to use, but definitely not like a power feature. There are zooms as well, which I've already added to my timeline here, and you can see that when I hit the zoom, it doesn't show up in the preview per se, but if I were to watch the video, you can see that it actually cuts into the zoom. There's not a smooth transition, it's kind of just a really quick zoom in. So here is the zoom, right? Let's show you exactly where I'm going to zoom. It's right in the middle of the screen, and I can make that more dramatic if I wanted. And now let's play it back. So it's just a cut into the actual screen. It's not like a smooth animated in and out. You can change that zoom level either the way I did it or using the level slider right over here. Okay, so that is the editor. Let's go back out to our library and check out some of the other tools. We're gonna stick in the edit your video section for now, and then we'll come back and check out all of the cool AI things that it can do. You got some privacy settings in here. So if I don't want this video to be public, I can make it private right now. And then that link will no longer be a publicly shareable link. You can do other things like turn off downloads or hide your analytics, turn off commenting, and turn off emoji reactions. We're all pretty used to emoji reactions from Loom videos at this point. And then there's also interactions, which we'll get to in a moment. All right, I'm gonna skip to thumbnails right now. We'll come back and talk about these AI features in a moment. Thumbnails are exactly what you think. You can add your own custom thumbnail, or it will choose one from the video for you. Very simple. Schedule is scheduling the video to be posted live at a particular date, and you can also set an end date. So that's really nice if you wanted to share a video with a client during a limited period of time, you can easily schedule that. And in video leads, this is a really cool feature which will allow you to collect leads as people watch your video. So I can just turn this on and I get a little form that shows up over top of the video that people need to watch before they can proceed. Well, you don't have to force them to fill it out. There is this allow skipping toggle over here. So if you turn this off, then you do force them to provide their info before they can watch the video. If you just want to make it optional, leave that turned on. There are some integrations available for the in video leads, or you can just store directly onto Dan and then download it and import things manually. Let's check out those integrations right now. So here is a list of email marketing providers that are currently supported. HubSpot, MailChimp, Campaign Monitor, SendFox, Go High Level, SendLane, GetResponse, a ton of very popular tools are here. Brevo, Entreport. So probably gonna find the one that you want, but maybe not. And in the case that you can't, of course, you can just do things manually. There's some other integrations as well, like for meeting management. We've not talked about meetings yet, but you can actually use to Dan for your online meetings. We've got a YouTube integration, so you can publish your videos directly to YouTube if you prefer to do so. There's a Slack and LinkedIn integration, and you can also connect up to Dropbox. Oh, and hey, if you're a Shopify user, you can publish your videos directly to Shopify as well. All right, now let's get into the really good stuff, in my opinion. First of all, we've got transcriptions of our videos. Now, this is not automatic. You do have to request the transcription, but you click one button, choose the language that you want to have it transcribed in. There's quite a few to choose from here. You can see the list as I scroll through, and then just click generate transcript. It's going to confirm that you want it to do it, and then it's going to go ahead and do the transcript in the background. I can sit here and stare at it, or I can close while it's actually doing the transcript. That's just fine. I can also do other things with AI, like title the video. I can click right here, and as long as my transcript is complete, which I just got a pop-up notification that it is, it will go ahead and generate a title for the video. Let's see what it calls this one. Master Dadan's Screen Recording Tools, a complete guide for creating professional instructional original videos. I'm glad that it was so obvious. I'm an absolute master of this tool. If I don't like this, I can try another, and there you go. So you can just keep hitting try another until you find the one that you like, and then click use this title, and you can see it updates it right down here. You can do the same thing with tagging. So if you want to boost the discoverability, you can have it generate tags, and here are the suggestions like tutorial, Dadan, instructional videos. These are all tags that I want to use, so I'll go ahead and just choose those and click away. And now down here, you can see the tags that have been added. I can also add them manually right down here. Next up, video description. Simply click description and it's going to generate a video description for you so that when you send off your video to that colleague, they can actually know what's going to be included in the video. Very, very nice. Again, there's a regenerate button, or I can just click use this description and it's going to show up down here. So our video is starting to be populated, a really nice looking interface. This is, by the way, what people will see when they click on your link. They'll see the description. They'll have the option to download it if you've given them permission. They'll be able to see what tags were given, and you can see the comments down here. It's a pretty nice interface. You can even add resources. So if you want to upload files like zip files, PDFs that people need to download, you can just add them right to the video. You can also embed your videos on your website or other places, and you can see where it's embedded right here. Now, this is logged in as the administrator. Obviously, the general population will not be able to see this, but if you want to be able to share your videos on different parts of the web, you can keep track of where it's being shared right here. And of course, you can also disable this completely or just whitelist specific domains. Back up to our AI tools, we've looked at the description. We can also generate a summary. So a description is going to entice someone to watch the video. A summary is going to be like notes that were taken based on the video. So you can see it's actually generating the summary here. It's going to be a lot longer than that description was, especially if the video was, you know, any length at all. This is a pretty short recording, but you can see that, yeah, I got a pretty detailed look at how to actually use this tool. Very, very helpful. Even some chapter marks, some timestamps, be able to find the particular spots in the video where things happen. Now, this isn't actually going to be stored inside of Dadan. I'd simply just copy this summary and then maybe upload it as a resource or share it somewhere else. But it's really cool that one click, I can get a nice summary of the entire video. Even more specific than summaries are going to be notes. So there's an AI note taker here, which you can actually use with your meetings as well. So there's some drop downs here to choose what style of meeting it is. So let's say it was a sales meeting and we're doing a demo call or a discovery call. I can generate notes from that sales meeting in order to be able to see exactly what I talked about with my clients or review with management to find out how we can improve our sales process. Yeah, lots of great options here. So you're primarily going to be using the note taker with the meetings feature, but I can still go ahead and generate it on any video. So here you go. You can see what the notes look like. They are very detailed, even more detailed than the summary that we saw previously. And again, you can just simply copy this and then put it into your Google Docs or your Notion or wherever you like to store your meeting notes. And the last AI feature is translate. So you can actually translate your video into another language. And there are plenty of languages to choose from. So I'm going to go ahead and choose French here. That's what I took in high school. I can only speak about 6 words. High school is a long time ago. So we're going to go ahead and translate this video into French. You can see it's going to take just a moment to process it, but yeah, pretty great. Built right into the tool. No need to export anything and then re-import later. 20% done. We're going to be done here in just a moment. And of course, you don't have to sit here and stare at it, do the translation. If you want to continue working, you can simply close and you will get a pop-up when the translation is complete. There's still a few more features to check out. So why don't we do that? And we'll look at the pop-up when it shows up. So we've got the call to action, the interactions, and the chapters. So 3 additional features inside of the editor. A call to action. Oh, there is our translation. It is complete. We can click right here to open it up. And here is our translation right here. Now this is a VTT file. So I can go ahead and download this and use it on another file sharing platform if I like, or it's just going to be available here as a translation under captions. So right now it's English and I can just add in French. And then as I play back the video, here we go. I've got French captions added to my video. Pretty spiffy. All right, let's continue on. We're going to talk about call to actions right here. These are buttons that you can add to your video. So just turn this on, add some call to action text like subscribe, purchase, whatever it is that you want to do. You can add in your URL here. I've added google.com. And if you're not sure of what to do, you can actually have it generate a call to action for you using AI. You can see the UI here is a little bit screwed up because the button text doesn't actually fit in the button. But if you do this, it's going to analyze your video. It's going to recommend a call to action and even give you a URL that you could utilize. Of course, you can update this, but it might be nice to get some ideas. So I can hit use this and it's just going to add it right to my video. I can choose the style of button that I want, square, rounded, and then position it a certain spot on the screen. So we'll do center middle here, and we're going to show for, let's say, a specific period, and we will show it just at the beginning of the video and hit save. And now if I go to the beginning of the video, here is a button that has appeared on my video. And if I click it, it's going to take me to the example.com URL that the AI generated. Next up, we've got interactions. Interactions are ways for people to, you guessed it, interact with the video. There's quite a few options here, but basically it's going to create the interaction wherever you're positioned on the playhead. So I'm at 34 seconds. It says add interaction at 34 seconds. If I move this, it updates over here. So what's going to happen is I can add an interaction, choose the type that I want, a quiz. So I get to a certain point of the video and I want to pop open a quiz. Really cool idea. Or even just a rating, like, what do you think of this car I'm reviewing? And you can give it your own rating on a scale of 1 to 10 or 1 to 5. Actually, it looks like 5 might be, you know, I can update that there. When I try to type, it didn't work, but I can do a scale of 1 to 10. What do you think? And my rating can be hearts, smileys, or stars. And I can have people skip this question if they want, but at 1 minute and 9 seconds, as soon as I hit save here, when we get to that point in the video, if I hit play, it's actually going to pop open a little screen and ask me to rate the video. Let's try this. So here we are at 1 minute and 5 seconds. I'm going to hit play. And in just a moment here, our question pops up and says, what do you think? And I can give it a rating, hit continue, and then the video resumes playing. How cool is that? Why doesn't YouTube have some of these features baked in? It would definitely make people engage with videos a lot more. It'd probably also make YouTube a lot more annoying when you want to just chill and watch a video. But the idea is really good for marketers and people who are trying to get people to really pay attention and maybe learn something from their video or just check and see if they're still even paying attention. And our last feature here is chapters. I can click on this and add new chapter markers, or of course use AI to generate the chapters for me, which it did in just the moment that I said that. I can hit use chapters, hit save. And now on my video player, there are chapter markers. You can see them on the playhead right here. But if you really want to skip to a particular section, just click on this icon right here and you can see all of the chapter markers. So I can go right to that section. Very, very simple. So that is Dadan. Now let's check out some of the plans and pricing from AppSumo. We'll go to the plan details here. $59 is the lowest plan and you can spend as much as $300 on the highest plan. Essentially what you're going to get is more of everything as you go up. So we get 100 videos per month, all the way up to unlimited videos on tier 3. The video minutes can be 60 minutes on tier 1, 120 on tier 2, and unlimited on tier 3. So I feel like these are pretty good allotments, like even on tier 1, 60 minute video, pretty generous. We got transcriptions. These are going to be limited. So as I'm clicking that AI button, it's using up my credits. We get 120 transcriptions per month on the lowest plan, as high as 600 on the highest plan. And then AI translations per month, 60, 120, and 300 on tiers 1, 2, and 3. Here are some of the other specs. You do need to pay attention to how many integrations you want to connect up and how much storage you might need. You do get unlimited storage on tier 3, so that could entice quite a few people. There's also an upload size limit. Remember I said there's attachments and things like that. So 2 gigs, 5 gigs, and 25 gigs. These limits are great in my opinion. Very, very generous. Pretty rare you're sending files that are more than 5 gigabytes around the internet and you want to do it through your video sharing platform. That's usually more of a task for like Google Drive or Dropbox. So very, very cool. So there you have it. Dadan is pretty great. I really don't have too many issues with it at all. The one thing I would say is that I'm not a Chrome user. So for me personally to use it long-term, I'm definitely going to wait for that Mac app to ship. But overall, very impressive. I love the annotation tools. I used to have to use a third-party tool anytime I wanted to do that. I love the AI stuff that's just baked right in. Maybe if I were to be very nitpicky, I would request that every video gets transcribed automatically as soon as you hit stop. I understand that would probably use a lot of their credits and they've got a system where you only get so many per month, but at least give me an option to have it automatically transcribed. That would be really killer. Overall, I'm gonna give Dadan an 8.6 out of 10. This is one of the best tools I've seen on AppSumo in quite some time. Let me know if you have any questions or you wanna share your experiences with Dadan or any of the other tools for AppSumo's AI Week. Thanks again to AppSumo for sponsoring today's video. Hit that like button if you've enjoyed the video. Consider using my AppSumo link before making a purchase. Thank you for watching. My name is Dave, and I'll see you in the next review.